What's up, guys? It's your girl Sherelle Unique here. I am just chilling at home. So I wanted to do the D'Angelo versus, and I actually forgot that it was tonight. I really was just chilling here at the house, playing around with my hair and makeup and whatever, just doing girly stuff. And I happened to be scrolling on Instagram, and I saw that it was a versus tonight. So I click on there and I see like the layout, but I'm like, I don't know whose versus this is. Like, I wasn't sure. So I Googled it and I was like, okay, all right, D'Angelo, we can do that tonight. Like, you know, he's a whole vibe. He's a whole mood. Okay. So, and I was here for it because I've had a long couple of weeks, which I'll do a video on that pretty soon. But I've had a long couple of weeks, so I really wanted to just kind of just chill out. And this was perfect. This was perfect. All right. So, y'all know I got my notes. I don't have my glasses on right now because I was playing around in makeup. I am not a makeup artist, so please don't come for me. But anyway, here we are. So, let's talk about the layout. It looked really cool. They were at the Apollo Theater. I love the Apollo Theater. I don't know if you guys have ever been there. If you have, you understand why I say I love it. It's just a beautiful theater. And it was the perfect place to have this versus right during Black History Month. So I just think that that was just perfect. And D'Angelo kind of gave a story during his versus, talking about how he got his career started at the Apollo Theater. I believe he said he was 16 years old when he did one of the actual competitions, the amateur night, not the show, but the amateur night. He won. So that kind of got, his career started, which is a story I had never heard before. I can't say that I know a lot about his backstory. So now that I'm saying that, and now that I'm realizing that, I'm going to check out his backstory and just get more information on his backstory, because I don't know. You know, they spend so much time talking about him and Angie Stone's relationship, you forget that they have a lot more going on with their career. All right, so they had this set up right on the stage. You can see the chairs, the red chairs, the infamous red chairs. And the stage, it had like earth tones. There was creams and golds and browns, a little hint of like burgundy in there. It looked real classy. There was candles on the ground. Looked like they were like a mustard colored candles. It's just real grown and sexy vibe. It was sponsored by Ciroc. And then there was DJ Scratch, I believe. He was up there. He was vibing. He was giving us a whole vibe before we got started. Of course, with verses, they always take forever. I don't know what that's about, but they always take forever to get started. But, you know, I digress. So, D'Angelo comes out. He has this brownish colored hat on. He got this big fur jacket. I hated that jacket. It was ugly. But we know he's earthy. He's earthy. So, you know, when they got that vibe going, the Erykah Badus of the world, the D'Angelos of the world, when they got that vibe going, you let them be them, you know? However, I did enjoy the moment when he took the jacket off. So he took it off for just a brief moment, but he put it back on, and I was just like, all right, you know, this is what we're doing, I guess. And I believe he had, like, gray boots on. Looked like booties, though. They were, like, at the ankle. I don't know. I wasn't vibing with the outfit, obviously, right? Okay, so, and it was weird because I'm like, what temperature was it in there? Because the DJ had on short sleeves. D'Angelo got this big, full-length fur jacket, and it was a heavy jacket. It looked like it was bear fur that just got cut off the bear and put right on his body. Like, it was thick. It was a hot mess. All right, so let me see, because y'all know I got notes and I ain't got no glasses on right now, because I felt like the glasses was too much with the dark dark eyeshadow. I ain't going nowhere with this on. I just wanted a vibe tonight, okay? I was playing around. Alright, so yeah, the candles, Ciroc, earth tones, we spoke about all of that. So, you know, D'Angelo is just a whole vibe. That's one thing we love about him. Every song he comes out, I don't know what it does, but it just makes you just calm down when you hear it. Or it might make you just feel sexy when you hear it. Or it's just a mood. I don't know what, it don't matter what album you come from, it's a mood. And so I think that's what we love most about him. Of course, we loved his looks back in the day. Some might love his looks today. But he's an all-around vibe, okay? That's what we love about him. He sounded great. Now, I had problems because, and I don't know if anybody else experienced this, but the timing was a little bit off. So his lips was not going with the music. So at first I was like, is he forgetting the words? Or is the timing off? So I realized on my end, with my internet or whatever, the timing was off. But throughout the whole entire performance, he sounded great. So had I not known that it was the timing, I would have been like, is he lip syncing? You know, but it is what it is. He sounded great. So that's always a plus. The sound was great. We love that. Okay. We hate watching verses and the sound is trash. And there would have been no excuse for it at this point because he's going against himself. Like, he's D'Angelo, he's going against himself, y'all. Like, what? No, your sound got to be on point. And it was on point. So we definitely appreciate that, okay? Alrighty, let's go into more. D'Angelo doesn't give much as far as showmanship, but there are some performers whose voices and their artistry is so great that we don't need a whole lot of showmanship. He knows how to keep our attention. He knows when, like, there were still, like, peaks and valleys. Not bad valleys, but peaks and valleys. There was still a journey that he still took us on, even though he's not up dancing and giving us a whole Beyonce performance. He's still entertainment. He's still artistry. He's still showmanship. But like I said, some people just have voices where they don't have to have a lot going on while they're singing and while they're up. And he's definitely one of those. D'Angelo is known for his intros. I don't know what it is about, like, some of them intros of them songs, but you know the song as soon as it gets started. I don't know about anybody else, but I get hyped the minute that the song gets started. And so it's like, it's just fun. It's fun to listen to. He hypes me up. He's lit. All right. So let's get into this. He did a song. Now, I'm not going to go verbatim. Usually I go verbatim because I be knowing a lot of songs and stuff. I don't know all of D'Angelo's music. I ain't even going to act like I do. But I am going to mention the ones that I know and love. So that's where we're going to go with this. If you want to work a verbatim type of situation, you're going to have to go somewhere where they got that. I don't have that. But so he started us off with a song that I don't know at all. If you know him, please put it in the comment section. But the second song was Cruise, which we all know that to be, I believe it's a Smokey Robinson favorite. And it's just an oldie but goodie. I don't even know what this, away from here. I don't know, it just feels good. I don't know. And inch by inch we get closer and closer. Yeah, like, it's just a vibe. Like, it just feels good. Like, it makes you really want to cruise. Like, we're gonna fly away. All right, so here we go. Then he did My Jam, which I almost thought that he forgot this, but he didn't. He did You're My Lady, my divine. Look, he's just, I don't know, he's a mood, and I'm gonna keep saying it throughout the whole review. He's a mood. You're My Lady. You're my lady. Ooh. All right. Those dreamy eyes of mine. I love the feel of this song. It's just a vibe. And actually, ironically, I had just put this song in my stories just the other day, actually. I didn't even know that he was about to do his verses. So y'all know I'm gonna be singing these songs, the ones I remember. I ain't trying to like give y'all no whole concert or nothing, but I'm vibing. He then brings out Red Man and Method Man, and we know we love them. They came out, it felt like they were freestyling, but I was still here for that because they are just pros in the game. They're pros in the game, and we love them. So, yeah, shout out to Red Man and Method Man. That was a very pleasant surprise. Then DJ Scratch got his little shine on. I don't mean little, but you know, he got his shine on. I love hearing the DJs get their moment. We miss that in today's performances. So it's like always great when they get their moment to do their thing, because it just takes us back. It's nostalgic. It feels good. It's impressive. It's like you remember that there's actually a craft to this, and they're not just standing up there playing music. So I loved that he had his shine. So then I didn't know D'Angelo remade Feels Like Making Love. I believe that song was by Roberta Flack. I didn't know he remade it, but I'm here for it. I'm here for it. It felt good, and it made you feel like want to make love. Like I was here for it. You know, go ahead, D'Angelo. Go ahead, D'Angelo, for that. So yeah, I already spoke on that. Send It Right Back to You. Great song. Feels good. His voice sounds great. I love his falsetto. It's just beautiful. He just has a wonderful range. And I love the many different textures and tones of his voice. So, y'all. Yeah. So, then he's like, she's here. And we like, who's here? And I got so pumped because I'm thinking, Lauryn Hill's here. I'm trying to type it, and I'm multitasking, trying to cook, trying to eat, trying to whatever. I'm trying to type so fast. I just wrote up some squiggly. Lord, I was embarrassed because I hit send and it wasn't even legible what I ended up posting on there. I hope nobody I know seen it. But I was excited because I was thinking that it was Lauryn Hill, because I would have loved to hear them do one of my favorite D'Angelo songs together. Now, it was not Lauryn Hill, which I should have known. However, it was her, which was also a pleasant surprise. I enjoy her. I like her. She's cool. I like the way she dresses. It's comfy cute. She looked really pretty. Her voice was on point. She has an awesome range as well. She's a wonderful, if you don't know about her, she's a wonderful singer and songwriter and musician. So check her out. And so she did one of her songs that she actually does with Daniel Caesar. She did Best Part. You don't know me, will you hold me? I love that beautiful song. She sung that, and then she mashed it with Nothing Even Matters at All. Oh, that is one of my favorite songs by D'Angelo. Nothing even matters at all. Okay. To me. Beautiful song. Nothing Even Matters. D'Angelo, which is actually with Lauryn Hill normally, but tonight he was with her, and I loved it. It was very, very good. Then he hit me with my other favorite song, y'all. Let me tell you about this girl. Maybe I should. Red her bitch and her name was Brown Sugar. See, we making love constantly. That's why my eyes are shake like burning. The way that I'm kissing like any other way that I be kissing, little kissing when I miss socialism. Brown sugar, babe. I get hot off your love, don't know how to behave. I want some of your brown sugar. Oh yeah, vibe. Vibe. And my voice ain't even all the way here, but I don't care. That's my jam. Brown Sugar. Definitely one of my favorite songs by him. And so then, to close us out, he hits us with How Does It Feel? I almost thought he was going to try to close out without it. I was like, I know he ain't about to do that. That song just feels good. I feel like none of us know the words. This is one thing about D'Angelo. He doesn't articulate. I'm sure every song we like, there's a line where it's like, what'd you say? Even it started at some. I don't know what he said. And you know that you got me right where you want me, baby. You catch a couple words in there, but you don't be know what he's saying. But he sung the heck out of it, and it's fun to sing, and he does not have to articulate. It just gives us this real consistent tone that he has going on. And I enjoyed it. And one thing about D'Angelo when it comes to How Does It Feel, you know, I got to mention that music video when his body was just like body yaddy yaddy yaddy. Like his body was fire. Like he introduced me to the V. Y'all remember the V? He had that V right there at the bottom, right there. I said, what is that? What is that V? That look. Okay. Yeah. So let me make sure I miss out on anything, because I wanted to make sure I said everything I had to say. I did say everything I had to say, y'all. Everything that's on my list. He had other songs, like I mentioned earlier. Great songs. I enjoyed the whole show. I enjoyed the whole show. And so if there are songs that I did not mention, which I'm sure, if there are songs that I did not mention that you love, which I'm sure there are, please check that out. Please check that out. He has a great body of music, a great catalog. I enjoyed tonight. I like traditional verses where you're going against somebody else, but I like this too. And knowing he's probably trying to come back, maybe have an album come out next. So what better way to showcase it? He takes significant amount of time between albums. And I get it, because he's not making no bubblegum music. He's not making no, you know, repeat, go back to the chorus, repeat. Like, he's not giving us any kind of watered down music. Even if it's something you don't like, it's not watered down. You know, there's true artistry there. It just is. So I enjoyed this versus. I needed it tonight. I'm excited about, I was excited about it. And as you can tell, I'm still excited about it. And, yeah, I had fun tonight. So let me know what you guys think. Write below, comment, subscribe. And, yeah, this is your girl, Sherelle Unique here. I holla.